throwing out the bad signal to the people. Yeah. Let's go to here. Wait, what the hell's that? Let's go here. And here at everybody. Yeah. Damn, we got more people in the Discord. What's up, Greg? Yo, Greg, you got the plug-in boutique, or not the plug-in boutique, the plug-in alliance bundle? I'm gonna give you guys the Black Friday. This is what you go get on Black Friday. What do you get the producer who has everything on Black Friday? You go get this. You go get this. Make sure you go and you get this. Go and get this. You can get it for $29 today. It's normally $200, or they put it in that damn mix and master bundles. But you go get this. This plugin is amazing, bro. You put this on your master channel. I put it on the post section on and this is in my template now. This lives here forever. And it gives you a matrix of 16 tracks, so you take 16. I just do one, right? But say you're making samples and you want to get a mix like Came One or some shit, right? You take a Came One sample, you put it in here, you A/B it with your shit. It shows the frequency spectrum. It does the correlation meter, so you can see a stereo image, so you can see like the type of panning and the dynamics. And the dynamics and the loudness, right? So you could really key in and this, I mean, not only for mixing samples, but for mixing records. And it's just quick A/B, 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 right? And I, you know, this is something like I've showed how to do it with the Listen Bus and, you know, Solo. And it's also one of the reasons like why I have a fader port, you know, because it's just a push of a button and shit. But dude, fucking dude, this is fire. This is fire. Like I could go ahead and map this to, say I want to map it to my say I want to map it to the read button on my fader port. Or the marker button. Just go ahead and link it. Oh, fucker. Are you playing games with me? But yeah, all day. Whatever. But even with that, just boom. It's fucking. So I started working on this. Thank you. this guy right here, Metric AB. Secret weapon mastering. Those are the tags. It's mastering a secret weapon. I'm telling you, this is this workflow is so key. But anyway, I love this Starlight pedal, man. I need to look up how to save presets on my Prophet. So I'm sitting here like, yo, I need to learn how to save presets. There's a big button on here that says save. Let's see what happens. Let's see. Writing. Do bank one. Program two. Bank one. Program one. Select character. Edit character. So we'll call this C. I'm gonna call this CM keys because I like this preset. I'm keeping this. Okay, and save. Boom! That's dope. Greg says, thinking about purchasing the Yamaha Mo DX6, looking to streamline my workflow and limit my sound selection. What are your thoughts? My thoughts is you buying that is not going to do any of that, bro. I think that the reason why you want to buy that is because, you know, you're from the era of workstations and you want a workstation, right? But if you're, because here's the thing, right? You're not going to buy the workstation and then delete all your VSTs. So you're still gonna have your VSTs. You're still gonna have Rolling Cloud. You're still gonna have all the other stuff, you know. and you're going to get this Yamaha, and it's going to be missing your go-to sounds that you're used to hearing, and you're just going to wind up opening your VSTs and using those in conjunction with the MODX, and then you'll wind up sitting there like, oh man, you know, maybe I just use my VSTs real quick, you know what I mean, like just trying to make the beat before my wife get home with the kids and everything, just do this shit real quick, and then before you know it, the MODX is standing upright in a corner, not being utilized now. The board itself is dope, dude. Like my buddy Bob, I mean, he's got my old school motif, the one from the late 90s, and then that made him check out the MODX, and he bought the MODX, and or no, he didn't buy it. He works at Guitar Center, so he just spends his whole shift playing the MODX, and he pretty much knows that board inside and out, and he just, like, you get him talking about it, he won't shut up about it. It's a different camera, AD. I got a YouTube camera. No more webcam. Dude, this delay is life, bro. It's just what the game's been missing. Nah, I don't have a DSLR. I'll show you the camera I got. This is, oh no, this one. So they used to call these pocket cameras, right? Like, this was, you remember the era 6, you'll remember this. You remember the era where we were using like Motorola Razors, and the girls would bring these little cameras in their purses for the digital cameras, and they'd fucking, take a picture of me in the club. Hey, God, Jessica, come here, get in the picture. Hey, drop my camera. Like, you remember that era? The little silver cameras, like back in the Von Dutch era. You know what I'm saying? The you remember the trucker hat era? you know, the so those were pocket cameras, and they were like, they were like $300. They had the little thing on the back. It was the first one where these where you could look at the picture and be like, oh no, we got to get Jessa had her eyes closed. I was really picture Jessa. You're so drunk. My God. So yeah, so these are what these have evolved into is, you know, a vlogging and YouTube cameras. You know what I mean? So I don't know that this is mirrorless. But this is like, it does 4K. It's got the touchscreen display. You could do, you know, it's got this one. The one that I wanted to get was the Canon one. But it was just like sold out everywhere. And this one I could actually go to the store and pick up. And it was on, and it was on super sale. Like, this shit is normally $800. They dropped it down to $650, bro. So. And because the main thing with these, is like all the stuff that like the DL, like I have a DSLR, DLSR or whatever, bro. I have one. And, the thing is when I hook it up to the HDMI, because of when the camera was released, it doesn't have a clean HDMI, and Canon never updated the fucking firmware to the, you know, to this camera, because they want you to buy a new one, right? And it pisses me off because I got three lenses to it. I got the Nifty 50. Like, I liked, like, when I used to do the videos before, and I would start with like me, and I would talk about what I was going to do in the video and then go into the intro. Like, that shit was dope. But you know, I have to record it, dump it off the SD, like, no, bro, I just want something I could put into OBS. So this, you know, this piece of shit, you know what I mean? I put it up on a boom stand above my monitor, plug in the HDMI to a capture card, and the shit goes, bro. I didn't have to color correct it or fuck with the white balance or, you know, like none of the stuff. It makes the background all blurry, like it's a damn, you know, like it's got depth of field. Like, you actually have the 50, you know, the 50 millimeter lens on there. You can adjust the zoom on it so that basically you do have the 50 millimeter lens. Yeah. Yeah. The lens being the Zeiss lens, aside from it being available, that was a super bonus. So this, like, for being like, it's called a pocket camera because it could literally fit in your front pocket, you know what I mean? And then yeah, so whatever, man. That's a new camera. It looks very nice. Whoa, hey. Worry about my plays. Pump up the jam, pump it up. Yeah, your feet are stomping. It's all about stomping. It's got you. I want a place to stay. Get your booty on the pony. Yeah, yeah. Oh yeah, the picture quality compared to a phone is like, I mean, it's a camera, bro. Like, come on. this fucking delay, bro. Makes me so happy. CJ, appreciate you. First time, long time. I've never seen you in the chat before, bro, but I'm happy you're here. Thank you for tapping in. My boy. Oh, my man's up there in Slocala. Riding horses. Yo, not for nothing though. Not for nothing. Yo, let me find work in Slocala. I will fucking move to Slocala so fast. I will move to Slocala. I will move to rural Alachua County. To live rural, I would prefer for it not to be in Florida. You know, like, cause you're gonna live rural, you might as well have some beauty, you know, have some hills, some mountains or something. But yeah, dude. For real, they developed Ocala. I haven't been up there in like shit. I ain't been around Ocala. Fuck. When was the last time I was around Ocala? Probably like 2006, 2007. You guys listen to this loop. I gotta grab something out the oven. Here. change the pace from Jersey. It depends on where you go in Jersey, bro. Jersey's fucking, y'all like to act like Jersey's all like big city. There's like one small part of Jersey that's busy, and the rest of that shit is like Alabama. Like straight up fucking Alabama of the North. And it's a small state too. It's a small state. Most of Jersey is just fucking hay fields and diners. Tell me I lied. No, I love when people talk about Jersey like it's like man, like, oh, it's such a big change of face. Like, bro, y'all don't do shit but go to Chick-fil-A and go to Walmart, bro. Like, I know about Jersey. Jersey's fucking sleepy town. Jersey's got like what, like two big towns. Like two big towns, got like Newark, Jersey City, and the rest of it is just like towns like Millville, Deptford, and Vineland. Atlantic City, there's a bustling epicenter. Even Atlantic City's sleepy as shit. Atlantic City got two casinos. When WrestleMania was in Jersey, they said it was held in the shadows of NYC. 15 minutes from Philly. Oh, okay. I know exactly where you are, bro. I know exactly where you are. You were them gas stations have the amazing cheesesteaks. I know exactly where you are. You in Wawa land, bro. Thank you. Zach M, what are you talking about? Are you talking about a real thing? Are you talking about a real thing, or is this fake news? Almost caught a body in Wawa a few days back. No. What happened? They took the last soft pretzel. Wawa's taking over Florida, though. They're building them shits everywhere. Bro, don't tell me about no $3,000 SSL6. Don't fucking do it. Oh my God. You don't need all of that. Where's Justin? I need Justin in here. The worst was, yo, the worst was when fucking, was when Wawa came before St. Lucie, because we got so many fucking Northerners here, bro, so many fucking Yankees, and, you know, when they open a Wawa, they would have, like, you know, the free coffee, everybody come in and get free coffee, because Wawa does legit have some fine coffee. They definitely do have, like, for gas station coffee, like, I don't know, like their coffee's better than Dunkin' Donuts. Like I feel comfortable saying that all day. I would rather get a Wawa coffee than a Dunkin' Donuts coffee, and it's cheaper. But yo, like, oh my God, just so many people in there. Like, it's so packed. I just want to get a cup of coffee. So many people in there talking about, I'm from Philadelphia. You guys are going to love it. You're going to love it. It's the best. Like, bro, no, it's not. It has good coffee. Gas is pretty decent. Everything else in there is trash, except for like, you know, the fruit cups. The fruit cups are fire, but like, they made that shit sound like, oh, you could be eating here for lunch. Like, their sandwiches are trash. Like, bro, it's so bad, bro. Like, it's just all straight stomach ache food. And people swear you want to eat that.
Thank you.
oh, that's the one I wanted, but it's going to be looped. Fuck. It's going to be looped. Can I get it? Is it in there? What's up, Eclipse? Thank you. Yo, the fruit cups are fire, bro. Don't sleep on the fruit cups. The fruit cups are life. That shit keeps me from fucking eating ice cream at 12 o'clock in the afternoon. Get some pineapples. I gotta get a real overdrive pedal one day. I don't know why I cheat. Well, it was my first pedal, so makes sense. But one day I'm gonna be a real boy. Oh shit, is this even gonna work? Thank you.
basket.
Let's go back to the Prophet X real quick. Talking about Caesar. Your mom says hi, Jinx. Summertime in the city, and everybody's knocking up boots. It's 4/8. So what are we doing? Okay, hold up. Cowboys. Thank you. this. You don't need all of that. You don't need all of that. No, you don't need it. Don't buy it. All you need is Arteria. All you need is Arteria. I don't know what chord this is. I don't know what I'm doing. Okay, now we're making sense. Things are happening. Good things. Things are good. How are things? Good. Good. Things are good. See, I look like Stevie B. I'm not mad at that. I wish I could have grown that mullet in my lifetime, though. Really, really upsets me that I don't have that in my life. I'm not mad at any of this. I'm not mad at any of it. This is all coming together quite nice. Quite nice. If you guys want to learn how I make these sample maker templates, sample class. Sample class. Sign up for sample class. Sign it up. Thank you. Oh, I think I like that. Hold on, let me get You know what we gotta do to make it complete? This starlight. I can't believe I've been sleeping on this star. Actually, I can. That's what I do. That is exactly what I do. And then everybody gets mad at me, like, I can't believe you've had that for so long and you didn't use it. Could have been using it this whole time, CMP. So what I realized about using the 404 the other day, like trying to jump into it real quick, is that the 404 has changed it. Like if you use the 404 and you are, you're familiar with it and you make beats in it, like you're one of them type of people and you've got like a mastery of it, you could probably jump into the MK2 and have a little bit more, familiarity with the workspace. But for me, like they added so much stuff on, and you know, all I used to do with my other 404 was use like a giant guitar pedal, right? So now there's two different layers of effects. Like I knew that there was pages inside here, but I had no idea how to turn the pages. I knew that there was parameters inside the effects that I was using that I wasn't hitting and shit like that. So I'm not going to be fucking with the 404 on stream until I watch that Av McCree video where he like gives people the crash course on how to use it, because I'm not good with it just yet. And I'm trying to do stuff and I'm missing out. Thank you. So yeah, the SP404 Mark II, like it's a brand new, like, bro, it's a brand new OS. You know, so. That's what we're dealing with here. What kind of texture should I put under here? His fucking pupils got evolving tapis. Like, this is like really the most comprehensive. Like, you get this texture pack from Pupil. You never need another texture pack. I'll tell you what, I don't need all this. Kevin D says, given you're mainly using the SP as an effects pedal, what effects on the MK2 are must-haves for you to get rid of the 404A? Well, first of all, I didn't get rid of the 404. Or what supplemental features are you using in the workflow? I am using Pupil. I'm going to punch you, dog. Like, why are you spreading rumors? You're a fucking trash can, bro. Like, you know, I'm having problems. You know, I want the Juno chorus. You know, I want an outside version of the Juno chorus so that my Juno can be a fucking Juno again. And you're out here saying that the Juno chorus is on the SP404, and then you drop an I think. And I was getting ready to, like, just plug my Juno back in. And now, like, you're trash. Just want you to know that. Thank you. But yeah, Kevin, basically I don't have enough time with the unit to be able to say like, yo, is the hype worth it or whatever. Fucking pupil. Now I'm piece of shit pupil. You gotta do this to me. I just want a real Juno chorus. That's all I want. Oh God, there's a button. Like there's a button to make it so that I could so that the page stays on. I don't know what the page. What was it? Ah, remain. Remain there. No. Whatever. So, how do you turn the pages? So you have scatter, down, turn. Don't even know what those are. Time control delay, swiper filter, 303 sim, 404 sim, cassette simulator. How do I get to the next page? I think you do. Ah, there it is. Okay. It's got the Juno chorus. Yo, it's got the Juno chorus. Yes, it does. Oh my God. So I could hook my Juno up again. I could hook my Juno up again and fucking turn my chorus chip off and go to town. Oh, this is going to be a big day. This is going to be a big day for old B-Train. Don't I, though, pupil? I mean, don't I? Easy, 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 easy bass. Gonna make an easy bass line. We're gonna make an easy bass line. Gonna make an easy bass line. Gonna have an easy bass line. It's gonna be a bass line that is easy to make. So we're gonna have an easy bass line. It's gonna be such a good bass line. Gonna be an easy one. Whoa, you just, where does this go? This goes to fucking 40. Oh my God, you're going to piss me off. You're going to piss me off so quickly. There you go. We'll take these guys and we'll drag them out here and then we'll do this. And we'll drag him out there. We'll take this piece of shit. Mm-hmm. Yeah, you do that. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay, hold on. Wait, no, I should do this the other way. Do this. This is a C to the minor, right? Just make sure that we're in here. G sharp is what? A flat, right? That has G in the bass. Aha! Let's go. There it is. Boom. We are Liddy McLittenstein. Uh-huh. What are these? Custom MIDI files? Yes. That's a little too much sauce. You know, there's a lot of sauce happening there. See if we could just take it down a notch. This has potential, but like everything that is a hack, we're gonna need to fix it. So let's fix it. So good. So good. I fucking love this plugin. I'm so glad you guys didn't buy this. It's all mine. Oh, look at that. Heavy memory uses. Watch what happens when I do that. It doesn't matter because of M1. This right here, this is all wrong. 16. What's happening on bar 16? Yeah, okay, so that should be all. Should all be down here. What? So wait, what's happening on 17? 17 is back to C. Let's make him something. Grace note. Oh, what is this? This don't sound good. That don't sound good. What are we doing here, guys? This is back to C. I got a feeling that's not what's going on there. Oh, it is. Why does it sound like that? This one. This piece of shit right here. What's going on here? Yeah, this is geesh. This is because we're swinging around. So we do dun, 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 bring this down. It's a grace note. What's the best easy bass deal? Just buying easy bass. However, like, you just get it. This shit, bro. I've been using this shit in solitude for like 2 years now. Is the upright bass a good expansion? I don't know. I don't use it. I just use the vintage, and I'll use, you know, one of these warm vintage pick, huh? What happens with this? I'm gonna show you this shit one time. One time, you ready? I'll show you this shit one time because you're just retarded. I'm sorry, I shouldn't say that. But we're not a thinking people. Watch this. Where are they? All right, so you guys watch me, right? So you're here with Studio One, and you see what we did with Easy Keys, right? So, and if you have Studio One Pro, you have Melodyne Essentials, which has the monophonic thing. So if you were to, you know, get a pack like this. So if you were to get a pack like this that has the playing style, and then you were to take those MIDI files and then put them in your user MIDI bank inside of Easy Bass, and you're sitting here like, oh, I didn't know that you could do that. And I'm just like looking at you like, how did you not know? How did you not know? Like what were you thinking about? What were you thinking about when you saw Easy Bass? Like, seriously, what were you thinking about? You guys know how we use these tools. We don't use them for what they give us. We hack them. since it first dropped, and I remember you were like, I'm not doing a video or telling anyone about this. Yeah, no. Yeah, I gave myself a 2-year head start, bro. Like, you know, now I don't care. Now I'm just like, wow, you guys are not paying attention. Like, you really need somebody to make a YouTube video to show you what time it is with this shit, bro. Dude, because if I would have made those videos when it came out, this shit would have been all over Producer Grind and all the Sample Maker channels. I'm telling you. But watch. This shit's gonna show up on Producer Grind now. Watch. Bro, I'm not even like, just look at what I'm doing. I am not going to hold your hand and walk you through this, but just look at what I am doing. If you guys want to see this on Studio One tutorials, or if you want to see it in sample class, that's what I need to do. I need to make an easy bass deep dive for sample class. I did not, I'll add this to sample class, but look at what I'm doing. Look at it. Look at what I'm doing. Look at what I'm doing. Pay attention. Just look at it. Yo, Cubase junkie, I don't get it, bro. I do not get it. I don't get it. For the life of me, I do not understand it. All right, so let me show you guys. God, I'm gonna delete this fucking video. I am. This shit ain't staying up. I got enough streams up this week. Cause this is some sample class shit. This is the kind of video that motherfucker hit me up and be like, yo, I want a sample class refund because you showed that all on a live stream. Watch this. But I'm excited because I just got this plugin and I want to share it with you guys, right? So check this out. Okay, so boom, we got this. For you guys that don't know, this plugin right here, you can get it for $29 today on Plugin Alliance, right? I didn't get an NFR. I seen this in some mixing tutorials that I fuck with. And yeah. Some shit the Seven Seas put me on to that he said I needed to watch. So I checked it out. But this is everything right here. So what you can do is say I wanted this sample to sound like the Drum Broker guys, right? So we'll go with someone dope who's got a Grammy. Let's go with a Grammy winning sound designer here, right? So I'll go into my sample packs. Not my sample packs. I don't have a Grammy. Let's go look at somebody who Kanye likes, right? So we'll go into here. We'll go into this and we'll say, hey. So we'll say like this one has like this, like something similar, right? Boom. So what you can do now is we want to take this, we want to go to playback. And we want to go to playback style and we want it to sync, right? And what this will do is it'll level match it, which is super duper important. Then you could go and check out this. It'll show you yours. It'll show you, yours is the blue. This is the reference. You can make them go on top of each other. So now that you say, okay, boom, like now I'm putting my stuff up against, you know, the type of music, you know, that's up there, so on and so forth. So now you could take and say like, all right, so I noticed that my baseline, you know, if I'm trying to go for this vibe, and this isn't how you have to go about your life. You don't have to match sounds with people and stuff like that. It's just one technique if there's a sound that, you know, you're trying to like nail down, right? So I could take I'll take a Pultec EQ, right, and just put it on the bass. Thank you. So I'm just going through it, listening to the bass, because I like the relationship that bass has with the other instruments. We could go run the final test. What do you guys think about that? You see the value in that? Am I bugging? Is it like not a big deal? How much is Easy Keys? I don't know. Black Friday, though. So, Yolito. You run that to fucking Moneybagg Yo right now. Thank you. Wow. I fucking hate the way this plugin sounds, though. Like, I hate it so much. Look how much of a difference that makes when you put Decimord on this. Yeah, that's fire. I want to make a beat like right now with that shit. What are y'all talking about? String machine is fine if you're using it for MIDI, not for the sounds, though. What are you guys talking about? You guys hacking the Easy Keys funnel? Save big. I want to save big. Easy Drummer, $70. Easy Mix 2, aka Trash in a Box. Yeah, I don't see any Easy Keys deals on this. Easy Keys cinematic pads. Oh, this is the Rhodes. Oh, I see what y'all doing. Okay. Okay, I see what's happening here. So you go and get one of these. You can go get one of these for the cheapies just so you could use the hacking. I like it. Smart. Dude, I don't know what the fuck that fucking pitch and time algorithm does to when you pitch up a sample, but it's like it just completely just like steals the goodness that's in the mid range. Fix something. This guy right here. You, sir. Thank you. amazing. Just fantastic. File. Save. Yo, the gain envelope, especially when you're doing audio stuff, bro. You guys want, you got, I want to play you guys that were here when I was doing this yesterday, because I was kind of tight, or not yesterday, the day before Thanksgiving. I was kind of tight because I didn't get to finish it on stream, and I was like, man, that shit was not done. That shit was not done. Watch this. Listen to this. Told you people, I told you people, I feel like the people forgot who I am. Dog, this ain't no Stranger Things, bro. this definitely is not Stranger Things. Once you put this into your sampler and pitch it up, AD Commit asks, have you found a love for high frequencies? I asked because of your tweet. So it is 2021, the year of our Lord, high frequency content. And look, so the way the decades work, with respect to film, clothing, fashion, culture, and everything, the way the decades work is the first 2 years of the new decade, you get kind of like a spillover from all the stuff that was, you know, culturally relevant in the last decade. So there's going to be like a new there's going to be a new sound, right? And all of this, like all of this, I think the first casualty of this, like stylistically, is going to be the super high passed shit, right? The super low pass shit. I'm sorry. All that rolling off your highs, you know, because if you think about it, the reason why the you know, the rolling off everything above, like, you know, 2K and all that shit, the reason why that stuck for so long was because of Drake, right? That was Drake's calling card. Drake and 40, 2009, they come up with a style. They make hip hop like low fidelity again, right? They purposely went in there with the intention to get rid of the highs and leave room for the singer. And then throughout the entire 2010s, you see different versions of that. You still had, in the 2010s, you still had leftovers from the early 2000s. And I'll show you what I mean, right? So here's a transition album. Let's make this a classic stream, guys. So I'll show you what I mean. I'll show you exactly what I mean. Let's go to a new window and let's pull up Tidal. So what the hell's the name of this album? Let's pull it up. All right. Pull up Teflon Don, right? So this is the beginning of last decade, right? You cement this sound. Cut clarity. My gun dirty. My brick clean. I'm riding dirty. My dick clean. So this really, like, I remember, like, this song in particular, this song and BMF, this got producer world crazy. They're like, how do you do the machine? They called them the machine gun hi-hats back then. How do I make the machine gun hi-hats? How do I make the machine gun hi-hats? Everybody wanted to know how to make the machine gun hi-hats. And everybody was like, yo, this is, like, you've seen it. This was this is what was going to, like, go. Now, there was still remnants of the early 2000s on this in, like, for example, check this out. So you've got the staccato brass stacks. That's something like that you would have gotten back in, like, Young Jeezy type beats. You know what I mean? But then if you notice, and, like, still, like, if you notice what happened to trap, when you think of trap, like when you think of like a trap beat, you don't think about horns, right? People don't really like put horn stacks on their beats. It's more of like synths and halftime samples, right? Like that's where you've taken trap, right? So with respect to the high frequency stuff, bro, like, It's just where I'm putting my money, right? I've been making like rolled off samples for like the past like 5 years, just because like that's the vibe. Everybody's trying to get their Drake placement or whatever, right? But you look at like how people receive Certified Lover Boy. Go on Twitter, read how people receive Certified Lover Boy. The beats on there are amazing, bro. The producers went nuts, like. All the producers went nuts. But as far as like the content of the album and how it was received with the culture and everything, it's pretty much like consensus that the album was mids. It didn't stick. Drake was mailing it in. I thought we were going to get, you know, something else, like the Drake fandom. It's just like, nah, bro, this one ain't it. So, and I told you guys, I told you guys back when I used to do the podcast with MG, like I told you guys, like Drake is at his Blueprint 3 album, right? That Certified Lover Boy, that was his Blueprint 3. He's never going to, like, from here to now on, he's not like going to be dominant. as far as like, you might be dominant as far as like popularity and as far as like what you see on your timeline, people calling him the GOAT and everything like that, because he's at the tail end of his career, but you're not getting that, you know, like from now on, you're getting way too sexy. You're not getting Marvin's Room ever again. You know what I mean? Like, you're not getting Aston Martin music. So that leaves, you know, he's still going to reach back and try to do his thing, but there's going to be someone new that comes on. They're going to have a different sound. And, you know, I don't know like where they're going to draw that inspiration from, but I could tell you this. His run has been way too impressive, and there's not much more that he could say. I mean, it's not even that, bro. It don't really have nothing to do with that. It's just how our society is set up. Like, you guys won't admit it, but it's like these 10-year cycles that like all of the shit that we do is, bro. Look, just so you can understand, like, I'm not just like making stuff up, bro. I'm not just fucking making stuff up.
Sometimes you feel like a nut, sometimes you don't. We're the world's favorite brand of instant coffees.
In America, Nescafe's great flavor comes two ways.
We're the world's best-selling tool.
Nescafe regular and the red label.
So let's look at this, right? In the 70s, instant coffee was the fucking jam, right? And this is what they pushed, right? And they pushed it in a way that, like, yo, this is like watch the way they talk about this coffee. Hold on.
Nescafe decaffeinated in the green label.
We can sure please you.
Same kind of flavor. Nescafe regular, Nescafe decaffeinated. What's your pleasure? Kind of flavor.
He's the whole best.
Great coffee flavor is Nescafe.
We're the world's favorite brand of instant coffees.
In America, Nescafe's great flavor comes two ways.
We're the world's best-selling tool.
So they tell you they're the best-selling in the world. It's the best coffee in the world. It's the most popular in the world, right? So it's the same fucking program, right? And this is just coffee. So you guys could understand this. And then they were like, okay, boom, we created this product. We're going to compete in this product space, instant coffee, right? And then the 80s comes out, and I'm telling you, like, this instant coffee shit, it was done. Nobody's fucking with instant coffee shit anymore. If you look at it even further, once the 90s came out, okay, once the 90s dropped, then everything was about espresso and cappuccinos, right? And it just switched the advertising. So anything, and these advertising houses, they do it for television, they do it for movies, and they do it for music. It's all the same thing. You get a product. In hip-hop's case, it was Drake. You get a product that's dominant for 10 years. And then once that group of kids grows up, then it's time to start a new group of kids that's going to have, you know, a new customer base, bro. And that's really all it comes down to. So, yeah. I'm telling you, like right now, you're still going to see. Yo, AD, and it's nuts, bro, because you live in New York, right? So you could go, and it's crazy, like, you could walk around Soho and look at the Korean girls and the white ladies with their fucking. I mean, bro, remember when I was teasing you about, like, yo, are you gonna be wearing pants with your ankles out? Like, when was that? That was like 4 years ago, right? Like how all the white ladies up in Soho, they were wearing the damn wide leg pants with their with this much of their ankles. Now if you look at all the fashion trends for pants right now, it's all like, if you got sneakers, wear them with no socks, roll them up so you can show your ankles, your dress shoes show your ankles. And that was like 4 or 5 years ago we were talking about that, bro. Like, this, it's all pro, like at the high level, it is all programming. It's all programming. Nothing is accidental. So when you get into a new decade, right? When you get into a new decade, don't, like, I wouldn't worry so much about, like, oh, you know, trap is done, we're going back to boom bap drums. Like, don't do that, right? But just when it comes to your sonics, last decade was rolled off lo-fi. This decade, I'm telling you, the difference is going to be the highs. Ah, shit. Why did I do that? Dun, 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 dun. Where the hell's my channel? No, I need to go to studio. Get my chat back. There they are. There they are. Bro, I was working in Brooklyn 4 years ago, and I was telling my girl to rock wide leg bell bottoms because the Asians look super chicky, and she refused. I'm telling you, the Asians in New York, bro, like, you could tell where everything is going. Just people watch them chicks a couple times. You'd be like, okay, I see what we doing. Now she's buying them, of course. Yeah, good, bro. Don't let up on her. Don't let up on her, because that's bullshit, man. I will love for the bottoms to come back. What bottoms? What bottoms you talking about? That's loaded. So how do I get... All right, so if I want to use this Jupiter chorus, I got to go bing. This Juno chorus, right? And I click, and then I'm here. External source. Okay. Oh, so they got they got all of them. They got the Juno 1, Juno 2, And then Juno 1 and 2. Then they got the JX choruses in here. This is fucking fire. Oh my God. Yes. Oh, Cubase junkie. They're already back, bro. Like, that's all women are wearing now. What is this? What did I make here? What is this? Thank you. Yeah, see this guy right here? This is a mix we could fix. Remove selected tracks. Julius Rogers like, damn, bro, I watched a few template videos last year when I decided to pursue music production and foolishly decided to do my own thing. After dipping my toe in the CMP process, my beats were trash, and then I just decided to come back into the fold and see what we talking about, culture and trends within the industry. Forgive me, sensei, I have strayed. Yo, man. I mean, the first thing you gotta do is you gotta have fun, right? So that's first and foremost. You gotta make sure you're having fun. But once you find, like, because some people can't have fun being relevant, you know what I mean? And that's fine. And I really just think that it. For me, I don't really have a lot of fun, like, making pop stuff, bro. Like, it's just, it's not fun, so I don't do it. What am I doing here? This, I'm looking for AB. Let's see if we could find a sample that feels like this. Maybe Al Hugs has something cool. This is more synthy. I don't think Al Hug does a lot of synths. To go back to Kane 1 for this. Playback mode, sync, go to the spectrum here, let's go here first. Alright, so that's mad loud, babe. Thank you. the fuck is going on with this bass line? I'm about to say this shit sounds mad rushed. You sound like a doo-doo bird. Still sounds like a doo-doo bird. That's my new challenge. Make a fucking vintage sample without RC20. Yo, bro, why would you want Nexus 4? Oh, we were supposed to be looking at something. This shit's on audio sex right now. Nexus 4. You know why they do this? Because they know you guys like fucking updates. Like an irrational fucking thing for updates, bro. So irrational with the updates. So irrational. Yo, PK, it's not the gear, it's the ear. Nexus sucks. But it's not the gear, it's the ear. Yeah. I mean, they had this. It's just they've been had this. It's just what'd they do? 16 layer arpeggiators in addition to the main arpeggiator. Ooh. If y'all were smart, though, y'all would fucking take your awesome, like, MIDI melodies, drop them into Nexus, and make yourself preset packs and sell them shits, bro. You know what I'm saying? Full visualization of the signal flow for real-time feedback. This is cool. This is cool. Vector-based GUI. Good for them. Good for them. Nexus 4. Where is the damn, what the hell was that guy saying? Ah, here it is. Speculations. God damn it. I thought this was confirmed. Oh man, I don't want to do rumors. Y'all just sending me shit to read to you? A new SSL mixer to kind of mortals can buy with a paycheck. Project Studio has been leaking left and right since September. Okay, so this is leaks. If you've been lurking around the internet here and there, you might have caught a glimpse of what the SSL Big Six is there. Oh, somebody fucked up. Oh no, somebody fucked up. This shit probably would have been out, but they probably didn't have the parts for it. We kind of help off from reporting leaks because we'd rather reliable intel, especially something like this. However, speculating about new is also worthwhile, especially something like this. A 12 channel with a 4 in the age. So here is a big. Okay. So the crumbs of leaked information are saying that the SSL 6 12 channel analog mixer. So they don't know anything. They just know that B&H Photo accidentally posted it. Oh, okay. $100 for that update? Yeah. No, I think I'll pass on that. Anyways, guys, I'm about to hop off and learn how to use this SP404. See you guys later. Keep it simple.